Hello. If you're new here, hi, my name is Teddy, and on this YouTube channel, usually I make character design videos for my own hypothetical rewrite of Winx Club. So if you're interested in that, feel free to check them out. But today is not Winx. Today, we're taking a look at some iconic werewolves from the world of Monster High. Spoilers for the 2023 cartoon. Kind of course. I decided to pair the redesigns for Howleen and Claudine together in one video because I want them both fresh in my mind as I work on the other. Originally, they're sisters, two of many siblings, but in the reboot, they aren't even related.
I'm Howleen, command of Monster High's Werewolf Council.
Second in command.
Only because I'm younger, Romulus.
It makes sense based on what they did with Claudine's character. She starts out the show as a lone wolf and meets Howleen later on as she learns about Monster High's wolf pack. I do think they could have made it work if they kept Howleen as Selena and Apollo's second daughter. I guess going by like Harleen, I think that's the non-pun version of Howleen. And technically that would make her simultaneously a middle child and the youngest, which I think fits her. However, I understand why they decided to make the wolf family a lot smaller. It probably creates a bigger impact for Claudine to go from being an only child to having a brother than it would if she went from having one sibling to two. And it would have been harder to have both of them be able to transform with only one Moonclaw, which is an artifact from the reboot that lets Claudine transform whenever she wants, with or without the full moon, and like something with instincts, and I think it makes her stronger. You know, I wonder if Claude seemingly having been born in his werewolf form, unlike Claudine who grew up thinking she was human, means that Selena was in wolf form when she gave birth to him in Behem, and she was in human form when she gave birth to Claudine in the human world? Very interesting. It seems as though most were-monsters are born as were-babies because Torelai mentions that as teenagers, they probably wouldn't have human transformations yet, even though some of them do. So they must live out their childhood as were-monsters, but Claudine didn't, so why did- Anyway, I'm ranting, I'm getting off topic, back to Howleen, sorry. I can come to terms with them not being sisters anymore, but I still don't really like the direction they went with for Howleen's design and character reboot. It's a good design, don't get me wrong. I actually really like it just like as a general character design. It's just not what I wanted for Howleen. Actually, it's a lot closer to what I wish they did with Claudine's Gen 3 design, but I'll talk about that later. To me, Howleen is a scrappy little puppy of a werewolf. I love her little folded ear. Like, tell me that doesn't scream puppy. I think she needs a more skater-based fashion sense. The rest of the wolf pack are skaters, and like they definitely could give early 2000s Mallrat with a few tweaks. They gave Howleen this kind of like bad bitch energy to her design though, as bad bitch as a teenager can be. They made her more confident and easygoing and like good at taking charge despite being second in command of the wolf pack. And she is still the youngest. I don't know, I feel like OG Howleen was kind of messy and I really liked that about her. It was fun.
Don't go falling into that I gotta get a boyfriend trap.
Why? Cause I'm too young?
Actually, now that I think about it, all of the OGs are messy, but her especially, since she's a little sister. I've really always had such a soft spot for Howleen, especially her original design. It's so cute, and I'm a sucker for a big sister-little sister relationship since I have a little sister of my own. The way their relationship was in the original actually did remind me of us sometimes. I just really wish they didn't change her so drastically, design-wise, so early on. Like, in Gen 1. They just got rid of a bunch of the parts of her style that made her unique in the cast. They gave her the freaking Musa treatment, dude. Made her dress girlier and gave her longer hair. Ugh. The fun punky bits of her style have been reduced to whispers just in the second version of Gen 1. It just goes downhill from there. Like, I did a little poll on my community tab to see which version of her you guys like the best, and when I was making it, I genuinely couldn't remember what she even looked like in Gen 2 until I looked it up, and yeah, it just There's nothing special about this design to me. Like, yeah, it looks good, but is it interesting? Not really, not to me. Especially amongst all of the other characters that are in Monster High. Does that make sense? Anyways, I want her to be a little more of a tomboy. This Howleen still seems kind of rough and tumble, but I feel like she just has to be more scrappy or something. I really like Howleen as a little brat that's still learning about herself and making mistakes.
I just don't get what your whole thing up is with being popular.
Someday, I'm gonna run this school, and then they'll all be sorry.
Whoa.
And is maybe a bit impulsive and brash.
Well, I really wish we weren't in detention anymore. As you wish.
Especially next to Claudine, who I see as a lot more level-headed and sure of herself. I really like the pose that I gave her. Pretty much off the bat, I was like, yes! It's giving that fun energy, but she's still got both feet planted on the ground. Speaking of her feet, should they be paws, wolf legs, or human legs? We're gonna have to kind of find that balance here, cause I'm not super great at doing anthro. Oh my gosh. We definitely ended up with a combination of it here. Like, her legs are pretty wolfy, but she's able to wear normal shoes because you just can't do a Monster High redesign if you're not giving them shoes. But I like them having their big old paws out because they are monsters. It's just, I feel like for these designs, we gotta give them shoes. It's part of the outfits. So I'm justifying it to myself by saying that in the monster world, there's gotta be people that make shoes for paws. I'm sure there's tons of werewolves out there. So yeah, I gave her more of a tomboyish vibe. I was pretty sure I wanted her in baggy pants that sag and reveal the waistline of her boxers. And I thought those kind of longer knee-length shorts had that skatery feel that I was talking about. So I just combined the two and ended up with this. I love the tattered hem for a werewolf. It's a design detail. A lot of ghouls can work in Monster High for different reasons, but I really like it for weremonsters. The classic full moon transformations usually end up tearing clothes in the process of growing larger and more violent, and I like it as an allusion to their massive claws and teeth being able to shred pretty much anything. Also, do you like the little pun on the waistline of her boxers? I was pretty happy with that. Her shirt is oversized, but in the effort to not have her just be swimming in her clothes, I decided to crop it by having her tuck it up underneath her bra, which is probably a sports bra. This has the added benefit of showing off more of her tummy so I can draw all of that nice soft fur. And I just had to give her that little happy trail detail. It's all fur, but you know, it's there, it's implied. One of my favorite things about Howleen's original design is her short hair. It's something kind of rare in Monster High. I was pretty disappointed when they changed it to the long pink hair. It just lost that spark of uniqueness. So I was really excited to give her a nice cool short hairstyle. And when I saw this photo, it instantly went into my mood board for Howleen, and I'm so glad because I think it's just such a good fit for her, both in style and personality. So now instead of having the short banana curls, she's rocking this sick spiky mullet mohawk. I think the person in the photo has 4C hair, so that's what we'll say Howleen has too. I don't think the rest of her fur would have those tight coils though. I guess I imagine werewolves to have different textures on their heads like normal humans do, but then the rest of their body is like wolf fur or whatever animal they are, you know, because like Mouse Sadie's is a were-mouse. Speaking of animal types, I think it would be cool to make Howleen a different species than Claudine and Claude, since in the reboot she isn't actually related to them, and it would kind of just be another way to emphasize that. Obviously, whatever wolf it is has to be orange, so I was thinking maybe an Ethiopian wolf, since they're the right color and pretty small compared to other wolves. But I also kind of want her to be a maned wolf, because they have more black in their fur and on the edges of their legs, and I think that works for this version of Howleen, since she is a bit more edgy. It was really hard to pick because they're both really cool animals, but ultimately, I think the maned wolf is the way to go because of their spiky mane. Plus, since she's no longer Claude and Claudine's sister, she isn't actually a member of the wolf family anymore, because that's their last name. So if she's a maned wolf werewolf, she can still be called a wolf despite not truly being one, like taxonomically. I thought it was clever at least, okay? Although they definitely don't have floppy ears, but it's fine. I'm keeping it as a character thing. It's fine. They're magical creatures. Oh, I also gave her a bunch of ear piercings and a bridge piercing, but since she's a werewolf, it's like on the top of her snout. I think bridge piercings are so cool. Oh my god, can you believe I almost forgot to give her a tail? I always wish the Monster High werewolves had tails. I don't understand why they don't. Come on. But that definitely makes this just a furry, right? Like, I wanted to have the weremonsters have more traits of the species they're a were version of, but like, that just makes this a furry design, doesn't it? Not that I have anything against furry designs, I'm just not especially good at them. Yeah, I'm not that good at anthro art. I'm being so real with you right now. I was stressing about drawing these monsters, and it's especially true for canids. I was a warrior cat's kid, so we'll see how I do when I get to Torelai, but yeah, I'm a cat person. I've always struggled with drawing dogs. I can think of like two I've ever drawn that were okay enough to put out into the world. Like, I'm not super pleased with how her close-up portrait looks. I think it might be something about the muzzle seems off. Maybe the teeth? I really tried my best on the teeth, but I'm not quite sure I got them. If you have any tips, let me know. I know I need to do studies. I don't really have time, but I know I need to do them. I didn't go super crazy on Howlin's outfit, partly because I think something a bit less effort fits her personality here better, but also because I put quite a bit of detail into her actual fur. Maned wolves have pretty distinctive markings, and I definitely wanted her to have them because they look so cool, and I'm really happy with the way they look on her. I'm a sucker for that kind of character design trope, like having someone's arm darken as they go to the fingers. I did it with the Trix's witch forms and Twyla too, but she already had it in her design. But still, I guess I know that not everyone is gonna like this interpretation of her, but I'm so happy with it that I do not care. This is the kind of female character I would have loved to see as a kid. I was definitely a tomboy, and I went through that phase where I hated pink and girly things. It would have been so cool to have a character like this, being friends with all the hyper-feminine characters Monster High is known for, and I gave her pink nails just as a nod to that. Claudine is one of the original main three ghouls, in my opinion.
Claudine Wolf here, pleasure to greet you. I am one fierce fashionista.
I know there's more characters that are part of the core group, but I've always thought of Claudine, Draculaura, and Frankie as being the three protagonists of the franchise. And it seems like the reboot felt that way as well, because they're literally roommates together. They all live in the main character room. But in the reboot, Claudine is actually kind of the main character. Like, she's the one that sets the whole story of the show in motion. I will say, I never actually felt like Monster High needed a chosen one type protagonist like Aang or Bloom. It was enough just meeting all the different monsters and learning about their stories. I also feel like Monster High maybe didn't have the right kind of world for that plot, since the world building itself is more about puns and spooky aesthetics, as opposed to exploring an actual monster society living under our nose, and like how all of that would function and logically exist. I think the reboot might be trying to rectify that though, at least. They give a little bit more information about how stuff works, like the cloaking shield around the school and the fact that weremonsters have a leader in charge of them specifically, I guess. And that leader gets to have this artifact called the Moonclaw that lets them transform at will whenever they want. Meanwhile, everyone else can only turn human during the full moon. Though, I actually hate that they need to be in direct moonlight for it to work. What's even the point if that's the case, you know? Like, you can't ever go indoors if you want to stay transformed. It's kind of silly. It's also interesting that, like I mentioned before, you don't get your transformation until your teens, I think.
Claudine gets to go human whenever because of the moon claw, but it's not like the rest of us teenagers have gotten our transformation yet.
About that.
I've been transforming for months.
Oh.
I like that, actually. I don't know. I think that Gen 3 Claudine is very controversial. A lot of people really like her, and a lot of people are mad that she's dorky now. I personally like her, but I definitely have to mentally separate her from the Gen 1 version I remember. Like, I have to kind of pretend there was never another version of her and look at her from fresh eyes. Despite this, I do really miss OG Claudine. She was so cool. I looked up to her when I was a kid. The most egregious thing they did to her, in my opinion, is ditching her Brooklyn accent. I loved the way she talks and how it fit with her attitude and style. Clearly, I'm a little biased in that regard, but it was nice. It was also just something other characters didn't have, so it was another factor making her unique, and uniqueness is a beautiful aspect of these characters. I also don't really like that they gave her glasses. I have nothing against it from a design standpoint, obviously. I literally wear glasses, but rather more of a lore standpoint. They make it really clear that she has an enhanced athletic ability and sense of smell due to her werewolf heritage, so to me, it just kind of doesn't make sense that she has poor eyesight. I don't know, it's a pretty small gripe in all honesty, but that's why I didn't feel like giving her prescription glasses. I just feel like a werewolf would have really good vision. So yeah, I don't hate new Claudine, but I think a better redesign for her would have actually been the one they gave to Howleen. Just hear me out, okay? Gen 3 Howleen has got more of the aspects of OG Claudine, in my opinion, than Gen 3 Claudine has. But they're like updated for this new story and time period. I think they could have even swapped them entirely, actually, but I definitely wish this design at least went to Claudine if they were gonna use it. She can still be a nerdy loner into monster hunting and stuff, but have that more bold style and New York influence. Gen 3 Howleen even has a big black puffer jacket.
Are you from New York even?
Yeah.
Are you from New York even? Do you have a big black puffer jacket even?
It's right there. I think her ponytail fits for the new Claudine I've envisioned too. Sporty, but stylish. A confident misfit who is sure of herself and who she wants to be. I love the way that she strolls right up to this crazy haunted building and boops a ghost right on the nose, disrupts their whole deal, and then insists that she should be able to attend the school. She's full of moxie and a little bit of audacity, and I really like that. It's super cool for a protagonist. I mean, you guys know that I'm a fan of crazy anger issues Bloom. Like, don't nerf their personalities. Anyways, sorry. Got a little hot-headed myself, huh? If you see my vision of switching these two character designs, let me know. Am I alone? Probably, but if not, please validate me. And after all that, I didn't actually even give Claudine a ponytail. I wanted her hair to be humongous, curly goodness just cascading down her back, like luxurious hair. My Claudine here is still into fashion alongside being a monster fangirl. Women can contain multitudes. I think she pulls off jackets really well, and a few of her Gen 3 dolls have had jackets that look really good. All of those jackets are kind of cropped though, and I actually think Claudine's personality could lend well to the visual lines of a longer coat. I gave her this like trench coat. That way she can have it open and we can get the effect of a longer garment without covering up any of her wolfiness. Plus, it's a classic detective coat and she's always doing some kind of investigative work in the new series. I gave her some elements of her old and new looks, but still tried to keep it original. I gave her a fishnet shirt with a tank top layered over it and a checkered print miniskirt. I don't really have a reason for the checkers other than I wanted to give her patterns and I thought it looked cool. Yeah, patterns and textures. I think she would really like playing with clothes and appreciate the fact that a lot of the outfits she wears in the monster world, she could never get away with wearing in the human world without being stared at, especially at school. I did end up putting zebra print on her tank top too. Since she has this big solid color coat, I think the busyness of her smaller clothes works nicely. Then with her simpler solid shoes and more detailed hair, I think this design is pretty balanced. But I wish I gave her more accessories. I already talked about why why I don't want to give her glasses, but maybe I could have given her sunglasses that are just decorative. I think rings might not be great for her since she can transform whenever she wants, and her human hands are smaller than her paws. A hat would be too much with her hair. I did give her the moon claw as a necklace and a little anklet with a crescent charm, but I don't know. I feel like she just needs more. I just don't know what. Is it just me? Let me know if you guys think she needs more accessories, and if so, what would you give her? There's a lot of audience participation in this video. Oops. Oh, also, even though she is wearing heels, I think this Claudine would also be athletic. She's got this enhanced balance and agility, so she's definitely still sprinting around and doing flips in fashionable shoes. Plus, these ones have nice blocky heels anyway. I really like the idea of Claudine having curly bangs. I don't know why, I just think she would rock them. I did do away with the, like, lavender blonde hair her Gen 3 version has in favor of just a nice, pretty, warm brown. It seems to me to be implied that her hair color is supposed to be natural, and if she thinks she's a normal human with normal human parents, did she just never question why she and her mom have purple hair? I guess everyone else could assume they'd dye it, even since she was a baby, but she would know it's weird, right? Like, she would know they don't dye it. I don't know. I guess I could have given her streaks still, just to have the purple there, but it's whatever. I think I did a lot better for Claudine in regards to her wolfiness. I really like how her face came out, and I think she looks beautiful, but ferocious. I imagine the fur on her face is pretty short, but it's still pretty funny to imagine her doing makeup. I mean, she'd find a way because she's not giving it up, especially since now she can do these bright, bold looks without feeling like she sticks out too much. I did the same thing for her as Howlene, where it's kind of like canine muzzle on top and more human on the lower jaw, with them actually having a bottom lip. She only wears lipstick on that bottom lip because I think the top part of her mouth is just too dog-like that it feels weird for her to put lipstick on. Her teeth aren't quite as prominent as Howlene's, but she's still got those beautiful fangs too. She also has canonically and proudly, hairy pits in the reboot.
Oh, I knew my pits weren't furry enough.
And since I gave her a tank top and mesh undershirt, I was thankfully able to have them on display in this redesign. I remember in the original, at some point, maybe in the character bios, Claudine mentioned that she has to constantly be shaving her fur in the efforts of having smooth legs and arms and stuff. And it always rubbed me the wrong way. A major part of Monster High is accepting one's freaky flaws, so why would she go through all of that effort to get rid of something that was a natural part of her monster type? Regardless of how you feel about your own body hair as a human, no one should feel like they have to shave if they don't want to, but especially not a freaking werewolf. So yeah, if you have an issue with either Howlene or Claudine having body hair slash fur in these designs, don't even bother commenting it because I straight up don't want to read that. Thanks. Oh, remember when I said the most egregious change the reboot made was getting rid of her accent? I lied. Claudine in Gen 1 is canonically a lesbian. I believe it was that the creators wanted to keep her from being boy crazy to balance out Drac and Frankie, and after fans started headcanning it, they just sort of accepted it into the lore or something like that, but it's awesome. I ship pre-reboot Claudine and Draculaura so hard. They're probably the OG thing that introduced me to shipping as a kid, besides maybe Zutara, but I've grown since then. I'm different now. I really feel like they are as good of a match as Marceline and Princess Bubblegum, but they never got to shine because of the time period, just like Musa and Aisha. Plus, they introduced Claude, so then Drac ended up dating Claudine's brother, and I just always thought they were a lame couple. The reboot kind of fixed them, but I have a lot more to say about Gen 3 Draculaura, so I digress. I still think new Claudine likes women. I don't know if she's totally lesbian or bi. I haven't seen the movie still, sorry. But I have a new ship for her. And it's Torelai. They are so perfectly enemies to lovers, okay? And it would be a werewolf and a werecat together, which is so cute and has tons of potential for interesting moments, both good and bad. We know the reboot is queer friendly because of Clanky, so I can cling on to this hope that they'll get to be a slow burn for a while longer still. When season 2 comes out, I will definitely be watching, by the way. I'm super excited for more of this world, and there's a lot of characters I'm hoping to see make an appearance. The new version of Claudine has really grown on me, even if I miss the old version I was so attached to, and I can't wait to see where her story goes. I for sure think we have a lot more to learn about the Weremonster Society, and I think Howleen will be getting more fleshed out too. These designs are some of my favorite I've done so far, and I hope you guys like them. Thank you for watching and listening to me ramble about these characters for a while. I really enjoy the more conversational feeling of this Monster High series after a heavily story-focused Winx episode, but I hope to see you in that world next time as well. Until then, like and subscribe and all that YouTube stuff, and I'll be getting back to drawing now. Bye!